Hello, all you people out there in TV land. My name is CB Studios, also known as Kurt. And if you guys have been following me on any sort of social media for any length of time, you'll know that I'm not just into horror movie pieces, and not just into pirates. I love prop replicas and props from many, many different films. One of my favorite films and film series is Star Wars. A lot of people love Star Wars. I was born in 1989. I am a fan of the prequels. I am a fan of the original trilogy, obviously. And I am a fan of the sequels and the spin-offs and everything else in between. One of the things that I absolutely adore about Star Wars is the lightsabers. And so this is part one of what will be several parts of me showing off and displaying some of my lightsaber prop replicas that I have. The ones that you see in front of you here are both somewhat available, not necessarily the most rare lightsabers, but they were officially licensed and fairly easy to get a hold of. They were a retail item. We have the 2007 Master Replicas Anakin Skywalker, which is the one in the back. That is from Star Wars Episode 3, Revenge of the Sith. And then at the front, we have what was released as the Hasbro Black Series Rey Jedi Training Lightsaber from Star Wars The Last Jedi. Now, it has been modified from its original purpose. Both of them have, in fact. And I'm going to go over a couple of the little things that I've done to them. Beginning with the Anakin Skywalker, I am in the process, and have been for several years, in the process of building an Episode 3 Anakin cosplay. And I needed a lightsaber. A local collectible store near me had this for sale in, I think, about 2018, maybe. And I snapped it up. I had to, because it was an excellent price. It is a very, very heavy lightsaber. It's quite weighty. It is based off the Graflex from the original trilogy, so Luke Skywalker's lightsaber, but it is a redesign for the prequels. So your Graflex clamp band here is redesigned. It has some nice knurling that mimics one from the Lucasfilm archives. Slightly different T-tracks. It is a chrome finish, which is very, very nice. It is a fingerprint magnet, as you can see. But one of the interesting things about this one is the original Force FX lightsaber had a permanent blade. You couldn't remove them. This is from the Custom Saber Shop, a in-hilt Luxon conversion that I performed on this lightsaber. A really nice blade volume there. Removing the solid blade and the string of LEDs and putting a single LED in there. This just makes it a lot easier to wear as a belt hanger, because you don't have a 3-foot blade attached to it. And it means that, well, you don't have a whole lot of LEDs down the middle of your lightsaber that could break. They make them a lot more, it makes the lightsaber a lot sturdier. I've done the same for the Rey lightsaber, which we're just going to call the Graflex from now on. This was an excellent option for me to get a classic original trilogy Graflex lightsaber, as they were not the most expensive when they came out. It did originally have the glass eye button down here. This has had the same in-hilt Luxon conversion. This is just a kit that I got off Etsy, and I did all the electronics work myself on that. It does have a spare glass eye that I can swap out. I won't show you that here, but I used the original Hasbro button and used that to make the second red eye. This configuration specifically will work with the second red button for Empire Strikes Back, Luke Skywalker. And you can swap it out for the glass eye and do the sequel trilogy right. There are differences between all of the lightsaber props, especially the ones from the original trilogy. Different configurations of grips and D-rings and buttons and things like that for different scenes in the movies and different movies themselves. So that's how we've got with those ones. That's how they look. And they look really, really nice. They make amazing display pieces. They're nice and heavyweight metal. And with that conversion, you can put a blade in both of these. So the hollow plastic blades slide in. We have blade retention screws that screw into place, holding the blade so that they don't fling out while you're flailing around. This top red button on my original trilogy Graflex is the blade retention screw for this one. And then we've got a little thumb screw under the Anakin Skywalker there. I may end up swapping the voiceover for this because it's going to be pretty loud. And there you go.
even with the modifications, you still get those really nice ignition sounds. It gets that really cool hum that you get from a lightsaber. It just removes the scroll up and scroll down effects for the lightsaber blades, which is fine. You still get the clash, but whenever the lightsaber contacts something, you get that clash noise, and it does do the swinging noise as well. Really, really nice to still have that functionality with it.
And so there we have it. Those are my two Graflex lightsabers, my Skywalker family lightsabers, you might say. I hope you enjoyed having a quick look at these. There is a lot of information on doing these sort of conversions and modifications yourself. There's also a lot of people that offer very high-end replicas of these lightsabers. You can get replicas of the original Graflex lightsaber as a functioning flash gun, as the original prop was built from. You can get very, very thin, slim replicas of the Episode 3 Anakin from several makers that do fantastic, fantastic work. These were just nice, cheap, and really effective prop replicas from my collection, certainly on the right price point. You will see one final Graflex further on down the line. There will be a build video, or at least a modification video, of a real parts Graflex that I did last year. It's a little bit of an interesting one. It is the holiday special Graflex, and I'm going to be throwing some electronics into this one so that we can have a fully functional Force Effect holiday special Graflex Graflite. That's all from me today. If you liked what you see, if you liked what you saw even, feel free to give a comment down the bottom. Parts 2 and at least part 3 will be coming up very, very soon. We've got some interesting ones for you, some things that you might enjoy seeing. So definitely follow along, give a subscribe, throw a thumbs up. Other than that, I've been CB Studios. Thanks for looking at my lightsabers.